we're going to look at this question today. We're given three vectors, V1, V2 and V3 in R3. And we're asked what looks like two questions. Is the set of vectors linearly independent? Are these vectors coplanar? As we'll see, these are really two halves of the same question. So to approach this, let's have a look and see whether these three vectors are linearly independent. What does that mean? We need a non-trivial solution to a certain equation. So, does there exist A1, A2, A3 constants such that A1 times V1 plus A2 times V2 plus A3 times V3 equals the zero vector, and importantly, not all of these constants are zero. Okay, we always have the solution where A1, A2, A3 are zero. That tells you nothing. We want to know whether there's a non-trivial solution, which means they're not all zero. If there is a non-trivial solution, then the vectors are not linearly independent, but it will mean they lie on a particular plane, the plane defined by the left-hand side. So we want to see whether we can find such constants. We'll turn it into a system of three linear equations. Firstly, looking at the first entry in each of these vectors, we would need A1 plus A2 minus A3 to equal 0. This is the vector 0, 0, 0. From the second entry, we would need 2A1 plus A2 plus no A3 to equal 0. And the third equation will be 3A1 minus A2 plus 5A3 equals 0. Okay? Now we have a system of three linear equations in three unknowns. We're going to solve it using matrix methods. So we'll set up our matrix, write this in matrix vector form. We want to solve 1, 1, -1, 2, 1, 0, 3, -1, 5, and the right hand side, I'll put it in for now, is 0, 0, 0. And we can solve this using row reduction. However, any row operations we do will not affect this right hand side. It will always stay 0, 0, 0. So when I write it out again at the top of the board, I'm just going to leave this right hand side off and we'll focus on the left hand side matrix. Here's the matrix representing the system of three equations that we found earlier, and I've row reduced. In the first step, we just clear the first column. In the second step, we clear the second column, and we obtain row echelon form. Now we have a look at it, and we decide how we answer the questions we were given. Is this set of vectors linearly independent? We can see that there's a non-leading column. So the third column has no leading entry, it's non-leading. And that tells us that there will be non-trivial solutions to the system of linear equations that we had before. So we don't need to even find that, those solutions. We can say, since the third column of the row echelon form, I'm just going to abbreviate that, REF, is non-leading, there exists a non-trivial solution A1, A2, A3. And if you like, you could go ahead and find that. This means that V1, V2, V3 are not linearly independent. All right, there is a non-trivial relation that exists between them. So they do depend on each other linearly. In fact, they're linearly dependent, which is the opposite. And what this tells us is that they do lie on the same plane. So in fact, the answer to the first question is no. The answer to the second question is yes, it's the same question. V1, V2, V3 are coplanar. So we know that these vectors are coplanar. You can absolutely stop now you've answered that question. But just for our curiosity, let's explore what is the plane that these three vectors lie on. And we're going to obtain this from solving this system of equations. Using back substitution, you can find a solution that looks like this. Minus V1 plus 2V2 plus V3 equals 0. So that's a solution that shows, in particular, V1, V2, V3 are linearly dependent. But what does this tell us about the plane that they all live on, which is making them coplanar? Hence, we can rewrite, let's say, V1 as a linear combination of the other two vectors. V1 equals 2V2 plus V3. So we've written V1 in terms of V2 and V3. This shows that V1 lives on the plane which is spanned by V2 and V3. V1 belongs to the plane. We would write it in parametric form, perhaps, as lambda v2 plus mu v3, where lambda and mu are reals. This is a plane through the origin. And we also know now that we can write it using the span operator. So we can also write the plane as span of V2, V3. And this is the plane in R3 where V1, V2 and V3 all belong.